Hello. So again, we just wanted to continue to just focus on strength and praying for strength.
Amen.
And so the scripture that I have today is 2 Corinthians. This is chapter 12, verse 10. And this is in the Amplified. And it says, "So I am well pleased with weaknesses, with insults, with distresses, with persecutions, and with difficulties for the sake of Christ. For when I am weak in human strength, then I am strong, truly able, truly powerful, truly drawing from God's strength." So if you remember last week, we kind of discussed a little bit about strength and how we need to be strong when we come to new situations and things like that. But also, I like the scripture that it seems a little counterintuitive. So it started off saying, I'm happy when things are going wrong. I'm happy with weakness. I'm happy when I'm insulted, when there's distress, when I'm being persecuted. But the key part here is for the sake of Christ. When we do things for the Lord, sometimes we do things that may look silly, that may not make sense to us or anybody else around us. But they have a purpose in God's kingdom. They have a purpose in his plan for the kingdom. And typically, most of the time I've seen, his plan is to strengthen his children, to encourage, to uplift, to bless, but then also to give the glory. And so when we do things that will give God glory, we do things that are to help, to encourage other people in the kingdom and things like that, we may come up against obstacles. I love the kind of phrase we sometimes use in the churches that Christianity, your Christian walk is not going to be all roses and unicorns and ice cream and sprinkles. You are a human being, first and foremost, and all human beings will come against strife. All human beings have come against some type of obstacle, have come against some type of struggle, have had some heartbreak, have had some kind of pain. And so when we as humans go through these things, we have a decision to make as Christians. We can decide to let those things destroy us, allow those things to discourage us, allow those things to just get us into a place where it's just, you know, like the downward spiral. We can allow those things to happen, or as Christians, we have the opportunity to say, "God, this is where you show up." And that's the great thing about it, is that we don't have to be Superman. We don't have to be Iron Man. We don't have to hold and carry and burden and have the burden of it all. When we are broken, when we are weak, that's when God can be as strong as he can be. And that is beyond our physical strength. That's beyond anything that we can do. So we can have those joys in the moment. We can have those joys in those circumstances that look otherwise just all jacked up. We know that we don't have to do it in ourselves. And when we are weak, that's when he is strong. And so that's the encouragement I want you to take from today, is that we as Christians don't get a pass on the circumstance. We get access to the Father who will cover us.
Amen.
And he will take the burden. He will carry the load. So we are able to go through. We don't have to, you know, we're not going to be able to avoid, but we can go through knowing that we have God with us. God will supply. God will restore. God will heal. God will do all the work. So that when our bodies are weak, that he is the strongest and he's able to show himself powerful. So I want to pray into that. I pray that God will continue to speak to you. God will continue to give you the encouragement, mm-hmm. the strength to hold on. I think of this one photo. I don't remember where it came from, but it was like, "Hold on for dear life." It was weird. It was like a frog being swallowed by a stork, and he's holding on to his little throat, and he's like, "I'm not letting go." That's kind of how we have to be. We have to be so just narrow focused on God and what he is able to do, because we know that in him and him alone, that he's able to do and answer all of life's circumstances. There's no question too big for God. There's no circumstance too big for God. There's no problem that's too big for God, that all of it God has an answer for.
Amen.
So Father God, we just thank you for allowing us to come to you. We thank you that we as your children have access to you, Father, so that when we are weak, when we are struggling, when we cry out, we know that we have an answer in you, Father. God, we thank you for allowing us to go through this life, not alone, but with you in front of us, with you beside us, with you behind us, that you are all camped around us, Father, that we don't have any place that we can go where we are not in your presence. God, we thank you for allowing us to be a witness to your test, to your glory, that we go through these circumstances not just to say I've gone through it or I've gotten the t-shirt, but Father, you are going to get the glory. And then we just become a witness to your glory so that we can bring forth a testimony to your people. Father, we go through circumstances so we can be the testimony of your glory. So God, we just thank you because you are the one that's able to do it all. Father, you are the one that will sustain us. You are the one that will provide for us. You are the one that will not only help us to go through the situation, but come out better on the other side. Father, you said that we can go through situations and not have to worry about being destroyed or downtrodden or left aside, that you are going to give us the victory, that we are already victorious. So God, let us hold on to that. Let us remind ourselves each and every day, we are victors. We are victors. We are victors in you, Father. We have the victory over all circumstances. So God, when we go through the situation, when we press through for your glory, when we press through doing the things that you have given to us, when we press through on our purpose, when we press through with our identity, when we press through and continue to say, God, whatever you say we will do, then you will get the glory, Father. And we want you to get all glory because you are awesome God. You are amazing God. You are Father to us. You are our provider. You are our Alpha and Omega. You have so many names, Father, because you do not just one thing, but you do it all, Father. So we just thank you for allowing us to be your children, Father, for allowing us to be in your presence. God, continue to strengthen us in our minds. Father, continue to strengthen us in our hearts when we go weary, when we get war fatigue, when we get in battle scars, that you will continue to even heal those, Father, that you will continue to bring us joy in the midst of the situation, that you will continue to give us peace, Father, as we go through. And God, help us on the other side to be that walking testimony, to be that living testimony of what God did and God alone. So we just thank you, Father, for what you're doing. We ask that you will continue to keep us, protect us, keep us safe, dear God. Help us to see your vision. Help us to see your plan. Help us to see each and every circumstance as a way to prove more of your glory, to show more of your power, to show more of your presence, Father. Let us be the broken vessels that you can shine through. Let us be the broken people that you can shine through, because it's not in us. It's not in us, but it's only in you and you alone. So, Father, we just thank you. We give you all the honor, all the glory, and all the praise. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.